Hi, this is Mary with Adopt a Coastline in Seton's Village, Antigua, and we're hanging out in a mud flat, and we're hanging out here for a good reason. Not to get bit by all these bugs, because there's a lot out here right now, but we're hanging out here to discuss the black mangrove. So if you remember from the red mangrove video, we talked about how first come the red mangroves at the shoreline. They like to be covered with salt water pretty much all the time if they can be. And then the blacks are behind them and really only like to be covered at high tide. Well, if you look out over this mud flat that Jennifer's going to show us, if you look out over the mud flat, you can see it's dry right now. But during high tides, water will come into here. Not very deep, but there will be water that comes into here and inundates this area by an inch or so. So this is where we're gonna find the black mangroves, in the area where the high tide is going to affect. So what adaptations do the black mangroves have that designate them from the red mangroves? Well, there's basically two that's gonna make it really easy. First, how do you know you're looking at a black mangrove and not a red? Well, the easiest way is to look at the roots. And these things coming up here through the mud are not new plants that are growing in the mud. These are the root system of this black mangrove, right? So whereas in the red mangrove, we had the prop roots, which kind of branched out and stuck down into the soil. The black mangroves have their aerial roots growing up through the mud. And in a video here in a minute, we're going to talk about why they do that. But when you see these types of roots, you know you're in the black mangrove zone of the mangrove forest. Now, the other adaptation these guys have is when we talked about the red mangroves, we talked about how that salt is harsh on those plants and that the red mangroves had that yellow sacrificial leaf that all of the salt would basically flow into and then fall off. It's a little bit different with the blacks. And today, I have a wonderful assistant with me, Mr. Lukey, who happens to live here in Seton's Village and is one of the stewards for Adopt a Coastline here. All right, do you trust me, Lukey? Are you sure? Do you know me very well? How long have you known me? About half an hour. Okay, all right, you're going to be my test case as to why the black mangrove adaptation for getting rid of salt is different than the reds. Okay, so stand right there, and let me find a good one right here. Okay, you see the front of this leaf? Here's the front, here's the back. I want you to lick the front of that leaf. What's it taste like?
Salt water.
Salt water, he says. Thank you very much for your help. I appreciate it. Okay, we had a little bit of a break because we're getting eaten up by bugs out here. We had to stop a second. This is the leaf of the mangrove, and on the front of all the leaves, so you have the front and you have the back. On the front, in fact, if you look at it, I'll try to take a picture of it maybe and zoom in because it's going to be hard for the video camera, but there are salt crystals all over the front of this leaf, because what happens is the salt actually basically sweats out the salt water from its body onto the front of this leaf, and then evaporation happens and turns those that salt water into crystals. And so that is how the black mangrove gets rid of the salt. So we have three different adaptations of the black from the red. The red we're going to find at the low tide line. The blacks we're going to find at the high tide line. The reds we're going to find with those prop roots, okay, that look like this. The blacks we're going to have the aerial roots that come up like this. The reds are going to have the yellow sacrificial leaf to get rid of salt. The blacks are going to have the salt secretions on the front of the leaves. So that's how you're going to tell the two most populous types of mangroves here in Antigua apart from each other.